That the Lord will receive all our praises and worship as we come tonight before Him in Jesus' name. Let us have a word of prayer as we have our exhortation now. Shall we just have a moment of prayers? Our Father and our God, we thank you. Thank you for this privilege of prayers that you've given unto us as a church. Lord, we thank you because we know that we will come before you, Lord. That, Lord, you are willing to hear us. You are willing to answer our prayers. Lord, that's why we come before you, Lord, tonight as we come to pray and to exalt ourselves from your word. I pray that this word we are going to read together will build up faith in us, O God. And with that faith, we are going to pray unto you tonight. And, Lord, you will hear all our prayers, O God, in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray that as we seek you, none of us will seek you in vain. But that, Lord, as we seek you, Lord, we will find you. And great things you will do for us, Lord, as individuals and as a church in Jesus' name. Minister your word to every heart even right now, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Once again, I want to welcome us to our prayer vigil for the month of February. We want to thank the Lord because we know that as we've been seeking the Lord in this church, the Lord has been answering our prayers. And that's why tonight we've come again to pray. And we are trusting God that as we come together to pray tonight, the Lord is going to hear us and great things the Lord will do for us in Jesus' name. But before we start our prayer session, we want to exhort ourselves from the word of God to build up our faith. That's why tonight in our prayer vigil, we are considering the message title, Seeking the Lord in Challenging Times. seeking the Lord in challenging times. He provided the outline to us. We may not be able to go through all the references in the outline, but I want to encourage every one of us that we should spend time to pray on this, go through the outline, and seek the Lord, and great things the Lord will do for us in Jesus' name. Seeking the Lord in challenging times. We need to understand that times like these are not strange in scriptures. Challenging times like this, trying times like this, troublous times like this are not uncommon in the scriptures. These are things that even those who have gone ahead of us, that they experienced in their own time. Open your Bible with me to our text in 2 Chronicles chapter 15. Chapter 15 of 2 Chronicles. I'll read some selected verses there, but the whole of the text we are considering is from verse 1 to 15. But we'll read some selected verses there. In chapter 15, verse 2, and he went out to meet Asa and said unto him, hear me, Asa, and all Judah and Benjamin. The Lord is with you while you are with him. And if you seek him, he will be found of you. But if ye forsake him, he will forsake you. In verse 3, and now for a long season, Israel has been without the true God, and without a teaching priest, and without the law. And when they are in their trouble, they turn unto the Lord God of Israel, and sought him. He was found of them. You see that verse 4? That's our main thesis. And when they were in their trouble, they did turn unto the Lord God of Israel and sought him. In times of trouble, they sought the Lord. In challenging times, in their trying moments, they sought the Lord. And the Bible says they found the Lord, and the Lord, you know, delivered them from all their challenges. And as a result of that, in verse 12, and they enter into a covenant to seek the Lord God of their fathers with all their heart and with all their soul. They enter. When they saw the benefit of seeking the Lord in troublous time, when they saw the benefit of seeking the Lord in challenging times, they now went into a covenant with the Lord and determined that they are going to seek the Lord. They are going to seek the Lord. You know, during the reign of King Asa, the children of Israel were in their lowest ebb religiously due to their backsliding. Due to their forsaking the Lord, like we are told in that verse 3, where we've read, now for a long season, Israel had been without the true God. They had been without the teaching prophet. They're forsaking the way of the Lord. But when this king ascended the throne of his father, he brought the whole nation back to God, to seek the Lord, that the people enter into a covenant to seek the Lord with the whole of their heart. Despite the challenges, despite the trials they were facing as a nation. Brethren, do you know that in times like these, in challenging times like these, you know, in hardship times like these, in times like these, where we are going through this pandemic of the coronavirus, can I tell you that we as Christians, we must not forsake the Lord, but we need to seek the Lord in times of trials, in times of your troubles, in times of your temptation, in times of your tribulation, and even in times of your triumph. True believers will resort to seek the Lord for his strength and help, and not to forsake the Lord. That's why we are considering this message tonight, seeking the Lord in challenging times. For better understanding, we consider this message under three subheadings. Point one, we look at the command to seek the Lord. The command. We are commanded in scriptures to seek the Lord because we are the creature of the Almighty God. That's why the Lord gave us that command. Like you see in the case of the children of Israel, the command came through the prophets for them to seek the Lord. And the people went into a covenant with the Lord. And they now put a curse upon themselves, the consequences for not seeking the Lord. In 2 Chronicles chapter 15, 2 Chronicles chapter 15, I'll read verse 13, that whosoever will not seek the Lord God of Israel should be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman. You see there, they put that commandment there, that whosoever, because they've seen the benefit of seeking the Lord, the king have led the whole nation back to seek the Lord. They now have to put that commandment and say, whosoever, whether great or small, whosoever, whether mighty or big, whosoever, rich or poor, that we not seek the Lord God of Israel should be put to death. The children of Israel enter into this covenant to seek the Lord and made it a law for all to obey in times of their trials. Brethren, do you know in 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 11, 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 11. The Bible tells us there, seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face continually. We need to seek the Lord. In trying times, seek the Lord. In difficult times, seek the Lord. In depressing times like these, seek the Lord. In pandemic times like this, seek the Lord. That's why we've come tonight to pray, so that we can call upon the Lord God, so that we can seek the Lord our God to deliver us from this affliction, to deliver us from all our tribulation, to deliver us from all our trials and trouble. And tonight, as we seek the Lord himself will hear us. The Lord himself we grant answers to all our prayers in Jesus' name. Trying times, brethren, should drive us to seek the Lord and not to go away from the Lord. For the children of Israel, when they forsook the Lord, they were forsaken by God. And the enemies came to afflict them. If you go back to our text again, in 2 Chronicles chapter 15, 2 Chronicles chapter 15, look at the confusion. Look at, the conflict that these people went through for not seeking the Lord, when they abandoned the Lord. In 2 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 5, and in those times, there was no peace to him that went out, not to him that came in, but great vexation were upon the inhabitants of the countries, and nation was destroyed of nation, and city of city, for God did vex them with all adversity. For forsaking the Lord did vex them with all adversity. So likewise, there is a lot of challenges, conflict that await all those that fail to seek the Lord. The devil and his court are all out there to torment, to oppress, to afflict all those who fail to seek the Lord. Or we even go down to Egypt, because we are told in Isaiah chapter 31. Isaiah chapter 31. The consequences for not seeking the Lord. That's why the Lord is giving us a command tonight that we need to seek him. In our trying times, in our difficult times, in our challenging times, let's seek the Lord. Isaiah chapter 31 verse 1, it says, woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and stay on oxes and force in chariots, because there were many, and in us men, because they were very strong, but they looked not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord, neither seek the Lord. Condemnation wars, afflictions, sufferings await all those who forsake the Lord to seek help from man and from those with evil powers. He says, woe unto them, condemnation await all those. When you go down, instead of you seeking the Lord, you want to seek for help from man. There is condemnation. We need to put our trust in God in trying times like this. We need to put our faith in God. That's why we are commanded to seek the Lord. In Hosea chapter 10, verse 12, it says, sow to yourself in righteousness, reap in mercy, break up your fallow ground, for it is time. Brethren, it is time. When we see the things happening all around us, when we see all the confusion, when we see all the tribulation, when we see all the trials, you know, difficult economy hardship, afflicting the world because of this coronavirus. The Bible says it is at such a time we need to seek the Lord. That's the commandment there. That's the command, the injunction given to us to seek the Lord in times of challenges, in times of difficulty, in times of trials. And I pray that as we seek the Lord tonight, we will find the Lord in Jesus' name. But how do we seek the Lord? We need to seek the Lord, number one, promptly. Don't delay. Don't delay. Have you lost your salvation? Seek the Lord for restoration. Are you still living in sin? Come out of your sin. Be prompt about it. Seek the Lord for reconciliation with the Lord your God. Number two, we need to seek the Lord passionately. 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 The psalmist said, one thing have I desire, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Make it your passionate pursuit to seek the Lord. Seek him earnestly. Seek him fervently. Don't seek the Lord, you know, and your heart is not there. Wholeheartedly, be passionate about it. Let your soul, your spirit, and your body be engaged in seeking the Lord. Number three, you seek the Lord perseveringly. Seek the Lord perseveringly. Like that woman, you know, when he went to meet the Lord Jesus Christ, and Jesus tried to turn her away, but she said, no, Lord, no, Lord, even the dogs do eat from the crumbs that fall out of the tables of their master. She was persevering about him. When you come to seek the Lord tonight, don't just seek the Lord once and then you go and say, well, I've come, I didn't receive answer, then I can go back to the world. No, be persevere about him. Seek the Lord perseveringly. Number four, seek the Lord persuasively. Be persuasive about it. Be persuasive. Let your commitment be persuasive in seeking the Lord. Number five, seek the Lord personally. Personally, I cannot seek the Lord on your behalf for your salvation. You have to get saved personally. It's a personal decision. It's a personal experience. We need to seek the Lord personally. Look at Jacob. Jacob, when he was to seek the Lord, he said he did engage himself from the family, from his wives and his children, and he went to the mount. And he saw the face of the Lord when he was to face the challenge of Esau, you know, coming to him. He sought the Lord personally. You need to seek the Lord, number six, prayerfully. Seek the Lord prayerfully. As we come to seek the Lord tonight, be prayerful about it and seek the Lord permanently. Make the Lord the priority of your seeking. Make him the number one. And as we seek the Lord tonight, we will find the Lord in Jesus' name. But then how? What are the conditions of seeking the Lord? This leads us to point two quickly. Conditions forsaking his leadership condition, forsaking his leadership. You see the king there in 2 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 8. 2 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 8. And when Israel had these words, the words of the Lord, and the prophecy of Oded the prophet, he took courage and put away the abominable idols out of all the land of Judah and Benjamin, and out of the cities which he has taken from Mount Ephraim, and renewed the altar of the Lord that was before the porch of the Lord. He renewed. Look at what Esther did there, the king did there. He had the word of God. Seeking the Lord at the time of King Asa entails the hearing of the word of God. As we come to seek the Lord tonight, we must hear the word of God. Don't turn your heart away and say, oh, I just come for prayer and prayer alone. I don't need to hear the word of God. We are encouraging us now that we need to seek the Lord. You are tuning your ears and say, well, that's not for me. I will wait when we want to pray. That's when I'll begin to pray. No, my brother. No, my sister. We must allow the word of God to come into our life, to come into our heart, because that's the condition. He had the word of God. As you are hearing the word of God, let the word of God you hear lead you to seek the Lord. Lead you to seek the Lord. Not only that, he also took courage. You need to take courage. Don't remain in that downward state, my brother. Don't remain in that downward state, my sister. Take courage. Rise up. Rise up. Don't be, you have seen in your valley for a long time. This is the time to rise up and to come out of your valley. Come up higher. Take courage to come up higher. Take courage to do the will of God. Take courage to seek the Lord. That's the condition. And he put away all the abominable idols. All the abominable idols as you seek the Lord. Put away all the idols. That's the condition there. Any idol in your hand, any liquid in your life, any unconfessed sin in your heart, bring them to the Lord tonight. Bring everything to the altar of the Lord. Repent of them. Confess your sins to the Lord. Tell us to seek the Lord, because we are told in Isaiah chapter 55, Isaiah chapter 55 from verse 6 to 7. He says, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thought, and let them return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon them. And to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. And to our God, if we abundantly pardon. When you come to seek the Lord tonight, you need to turn away, forsake your evil ways, forsake your sin. If you regard iniquity in your heart, the Lord will not hear you. As we come to seek the Lord in prayers tonight, that's the condition. We need to forsake, we need to confess, and return unto the Lord. And renew our altar. All the things you've taken away from the altar of consecration, you want to bring all those things, all those consecration back to the altar, and give yourself to the Lord. Then the other thing, we seek the Lord in faith. We come and seek the Lord, because our human mind cannot comprehend the greatness and the wonders of our God. So there is the need of faith as we seek the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6, it says, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. He is a rewarder. You must believe. You must have faith. as we seek the Lord, we come through our Lord Jesus Christ and we exercise faith. We exercise faith. We believe that he is and that he is a rewarder. Do you see that? A rewarder of them that diligently seek him. This leads us to point three quickly before we pray. Compensation for sincere seekers from our Lord. The compensation for sincere seekers from our Lord. If you go back again to our text in 2 Chronicles chapter 15, when the children of Israel, when they were sincere and they responded to that command to seek the Lord, and they went into that covenant in seeking the Lord, and they fulfilled the condition, the word of God was read to them, and they forsook all their idols, all the abominable things, they brought it out and cleansed the land for me. Look at the word that God, as a reward, as a compensation. In 2 Chronicles chapter 15, verse 15, and all Judah rejoice at the oath, for they had sung with all their hearts and sought him with their whole desire, and he was found of them. And the Lord gave them rest round about. Do you see that? And the Lord gave them rest round about because they sought the Lord, because they desired the Lord, because they sought him. They were sincere in their seeking. And as a result of that, there was joy in the land. There was joy. They found the Lord. And not only that, the Lord gave them rest. When we seek the Lord like that, we will have rest. We'll have peace of mind. We'll have the blessings that we are seeking the Lord for, because great compensation and blessings await all true and sincere seekers of the Lord in times of trials, in times of troubles, in times of temptation, in times of tribulation, and even in times of triumph. In the time where you're having success, seek the Lord. Don't allow those success to enter into your head. Still come and seek the Lord. Don't say, oh, God has blessed me. Let me just go now and do my own thing. No, my brother. No, my sister. We must continue to seek the Lord. Remember the commandment, seek the Lord. Seek his face continually, because there are great compensation and blessings that await all those that seek the Lord. In Psalm 34, verse 10, the Bible says that the young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. They that seek the Lord, you will not want any good thing. Good things will be added unto you. As we seek the Lord first and make him the priority and the prominent personality of all our seeking, then as our Lord Jesus Christ told us in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, it says there, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Seek first, make the Lord the priority of your seeking. Make his kingdom the priority of your seeking. Make his kingdom work the priority of your seeking. And when you seek the Lord like that and his righteousness, look at what the Lord has promised us. This is, and all these things we need to better our lives here on earth. He says, all these things shall be added unto you. Additions the Lord will give to you tonight. Multiplication the Lord will give to you tonight. As you seek the Lord, you seek his face, you call upon him, great things shall be added unto you in Jesus' name. We are told in 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 22, all things are yours. All things are yours. All things are yours. Whether Paul, apostle, or Apollos, or Cephas, or the world, or life, or death, or things present, or things to come. All things are yours. As you seek the Lord, my brother, all things are yours. As you seek the Lord, my sister, all things are yours. The Lord has promised us things that we need for godliness, for righteousness, they are yours. As we seek the Lord, he says in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4, wherefore are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises. Exceeding great. Do you see that in your Bible? 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 4, exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partaker of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. All things are yours. As you come tonight to seek the Lord, as you come tonight to seek him, because we are commanded to seek the Lord, we are commanded to seek him, to seek his face continually. And that's why the Lord is calling us in times like these. In these times of the pandemic, we need to seek the Lord. In times of our trials, we need to seek the Lord. In times of our difficulties, we need to seek the Lord. In times of our challenges, we need to seek the Lord. Whatever your condition, whatever your situation, this is not the time to backslide, my brother. This is not the time to go away from the Lord, my sister. This is the time to seek the Lord, to remain in the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. And as you seek the Lord wholeheartedly, you seek him promptly, you seek him passionately, you seek him perseveringly, you seek him prayerfully, you seek him personally, you seek him with the whole of your heart tonight, you will find the Lord, and the Lord will do you good, and the Lord will bless you. And great things the Lord will do for you in Jesus' name. Tonight, as we come to pray, we've come to seek the Lord. Let's get our mind, our soul engaged in seeking the Lord, because that is the only way out of your challenges, out of your trials, out of your difficulties. And the Lord himself will give you peace. And the Lord himself will bless you. And no good thing shall be withheld from you in Jesus' name. Let's bow down our heads now, and let's begin to commit all these things we've learned to the Lord in prayer. Let's seek the Lord. Let's seek the Lord. Let's call upon him. Call upon the Lord, my brother. Call upon the Lord, my sister. Seek the Lord. Seek his face continually. Seek his face. Let's seek the Lord. He's a command. He's a command. He has created us in his own image. And we need to seek him. We need to seek him for strength. We need to seek him for our salvation. We need to seek him for our supply, for our sufficiency. We need to seek the Lord. We need to seek the Lord. Because if you forsake the Lord, grave consequences, conflict, confusion, condemnation, wars await all those that forsake the Lord. Pray and talk to the Lord tonight. You will not forsake the Lord. You will not forsake the Lord. It is time to seek the Lord, my brother. It is time to seek the Lord, my sister. Seek the Lord promptly. Seek the Lord passionately. Seek the Lord perseveringly. Seek the Lord persuasively. Seek the Lord personally. Seek the Lord prayerfully. Seek the Lord prominently. Make him the priority of your seeking. Let your heart be right with God. Seeing the conditions there for seeking the Lord. Let there be no iniquity in your heart. Let there be no sin in your life. Anywhere there is sin, anywhere there is iniquity, confess it to the Lord. Come before the Lord. You hear the word of God. Don't despise the word of God. As you seek the Lord, seek the Lord. Seek him. Seek him with your whole heart tonight. Come before the Lord tonight. Tell the Lord, any disobedience there, any iniquity in my heart, Lord, purge me. Lord, purge me. Take away all iniquity. Let me seek the Lord. Let's seek the Lord with the whole of our heart. And as we seek the Lord, we will be found of him. Call upon him. Call upon him tonight. Seek him by faith. Let there be faith. Don't come with feelings. We walk by faith, not by sight, not by feeling. It is by faith. Seek the Lord by faith. Receive the Lord by faith. Receive his blessings by faith. And he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Compensation for sincere seekers from our Lord. There is compensation for you, my brother. There is great blessing for you, my sister. As you seek the Lord tonight, the Lord will give you rest. The Lord will give you peace. The Lord will give you all your the satisfaction of your heart and of your life. You will not lack any good thing as you seek the Lord. You will not suffer hunger as you seek the Lord. The Lord will preserve your life. The Lord will protect your life. Long life shall be given unto you. All things that we need here on earth shall be added unto us as we seek the Lord. Let's believe the Lord tonight. Let's trust the Lord tonight that as we have prayed, you will seek the Lord, not just for tonight, but all the days of your life, my brother. All the days of your life, my sister. You will not forsake the Lord. You will not go away from the Lord. Pray and ask for grace. The grace to seek the Lord, that the Lord will give it to you. Seek him. Seek his face. Call upon him. And the Lord will hear you. And the Lord will hear you. The Lord will hear your prayers. Seek his face continually. Seek his face continually. Seek his face continually. In Jesus' name we pray. Our Father and our God, we thank you for the revelation of your word to us tonight. Thank you for the command you've given unto us to seek you. And that's why we've come this very night to seek your face in prayers and to call upon you. Lord, I pray that as we come tonight to pray, anything that wants to hinder us access to the throne of grace, Lord, I pray you will take away from every life here tonight in Jesus' name. Where there is sin, where there is iniquity, Lord, as your people have confessed unto you tonight, I pray, oh God, that you will forgive and you will cleanse from all iniquity and from all sin in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that the grace we need to seek your face continually, to seek you promptly, to seek you passionately, to seek you perseveringly, to seek you persuasively, to seek you personally, to seek you prayerfully and permanently, I pray you will give to everyone here tonight in Jesus' name. And Lord, as we seek you, great blessing, signs and wonders will follow your people from tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, as we come to pray, oh God, the spirit of supplication, the spirit of prayer, you will give to everyone here tonight in Jesus' name. And Lord, as we call upon you, you will hear us. You will do great things for us, oh God. Thank you, Father. Worship and we exalt your name, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.